Hey everyone, this is Noah from Elementor. Today I'll be teaching you about our portfolio widgets. This widget combines practical with incredible as it enables you to add any custom post type to your page in a very visual and unique display. So first we'll search for the widget and drag it in. And once it's dragged into place, you will see the content tab and the style tab. In the content area, you have full control over the layout, query, and filter bar of the widgets. So in the layout area, we first have the columns, where you could set the amount of columns displayed in the widget. So you could choose between 1 and 6. Say I choose 2 or 4, etc. And then you have post count. You could set the exact amount of posts to be displayed in the widget. So I could choose, say, 1 or 20 and so on. And next we have the image size, where you could set the size of the images from thumbnail to full size. And we have item ratio, where you could set the ratio of the images in the widget, say. Next we have show title. You could choose whether to hide or show the title of each post by clicking here. Showing the title will display it while hovering on the images. See it? Now, if activated, note how another option is added. Title HTML tag. Here you could select the HTML tag for the title as a heading, div, span, or regular text. So those were the layout options for the widget. Next, for the query options, we first have source, where you could select the source from which the widget will display the content, as posts, pages, products, galleries, or manual selection. We'll be going over the manual selection option soon. So after the source setting, we have the filter settings. The first one is categories. I can filter the posts displayed by categories. For instance, I have a fashion category in my website. So if I insert fashion and click on it, see how the widget only displays the posts with the fashion category. Now, same goes for tags. I have a devices tag on my website. So if I click on it, see how only the posts with the tag of devices are displayed in the widget. Now I'll quickly just go back to the manual selection option that I told you about. And here, as it sounds, I can manually insert the exact post or posts that I want to display. So for example, I have a post with the title of Tips for Vacation. So if I insert it and click on it, see how the widget displays only this post. After this, we have the advanced options. So the first one is order by. Here I could set the order of the posts displayed by date, title, menu order, or randomized. And then I have the order, where I could set as ascending or descending. And I have, last but not least here, the offset, where I could insert the amount of posts to be skipped over. For instance, if I insert 2, the widget will begin its display starting from the 3rd post. So those were the query options for the portfolio widget. Next is the filter bar options. So here I actually have a show option, where I could set whether to show it or hide it. Now once activated, another option is added, the taxonomy option. Here I could select the taxonomy from which the widget will display the posts. So here we have categories, tags, product categories, product tags, or gallery categories. So I'll choose tags and see how it's displayed up here. So those were the content options for the portfolio widgets. We'll move on to the style tab. So here we have control over the items, item overlay, and filter bar style options. In the items, we first have the item gap option, where you could set the exact gap between the items. Say I give it 80 or 5, etc. And then we have border radius, where you could set the border radius for the images. Say I give it 100, see it's completely rounded, or only 50, or 0, so on. Next we have the item overlay style options, where here you could set the background color of the overlay when hovering over the items, say pink, see how it changed to pink. And we have the title color, where you could set the color for the title of the overlay. See how it changed to pink also. And typography, which we could set to customize, which opens the standard typography options such as size, see, font family, weight, transform, style, line height, or letter spacing. And next we have the filter bar style options, where here we could set the color of the text or only the active color, meaning the color for only the active text in the filter bar. And typography, which we could customize or deactivate it. And we have filter spacing, where you could set the exact spacing between the filter bar and the images below it. And we have space between items, where you could set the exact space between the items themselves in the filter bar. So those were the style options for the portfolio widgets. So as you could see, this is an extremely helpful and fun widget. I hope you enjoyed this video. For more videos and tutorials, subscribe to our YouTube channel or visit us at docs.elementor.com.